إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، يقول سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه الكريم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. ثم أما بعد، My dear, beloved, respected brothers and sisters, I ask Allah Azza wa Jal to bless me and you with sincerity in everything that we say and everything that we do. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. In 2012, there was a giant electronic stores in Germany called Saturn. Saturn was about to open their 150th location. So they made a competition on their Facebook page. And the winner of the competition will get 150 seconds in any location and get whatever they want for free. When the date came and the winners were announced, there were three of them. The first, when he heard go, he went inside the store looking left and right and grabbing whatever he can. Long story short, he came out with maybe 1,000 euro worth of stuff. The second ran in the store, he fell, he kept on not knowing where the expensive things are, and then he grabbed maybe around 1,500 euro worth of stuff. Then Sebastian came. Sebastian, when he heard the word go, he went exactly where the most expensive things are. He knew what to do and he knew where to go. He even put two huge TVs next to each other and he made them a cart and he started pushing them and he started putting stuff on them and took that whole thing to where he's supposed to put his stuff. And he kept on going back and forth and getting all kinds of iPads, iPhones, you name it. And he came out with 29,000 euros worth of merchandise. And when he finished, he screamed and said, "My plan worked. My plan worked." Of course, as a matter of fact, if you go to YouTube and put Saturn Sebastian 2012, you will actually watch him grabbing all these things. So it's not a fake story. So when he finished, you're going to see in the video, tons of media coverage. They asked him, "What did you mean by my plan worked?" He said, since they announced for the competition, I came to this location every single day. And I memorized where everything is. And I started making plan that if I won, what am I going to do? What am I going to get first? Where are the most expensive merchandise? And that's why I said my plan worked. Sebastian's plan for gaining 29,000 euros of dunya gain worked. What is your plan for the day of Arafah where your neck will be saved from the hellfire? My brothers and sisters, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us many virtues of this day, and I will mention few for me and you to get motivated to start planning from today in order for our plan to work, our strategy to work. If you fail to plan, you are planning to fail. Officially, Tuesday is the day of Arafah. And it is, first, it is the day on which Allah Azza wa Jal has perfected the deen. A Jewish man came to Umar radiallahu anhu and he said, you have an ayah in your book. If it was revealed to us Jews, we would have made that day as a Eid. So Umar radiallahu anhu said, what ayah is it? He said the ayah in Surah Al-Ma'idah where Allah Azza wa Jal said, Al-yawma akmaltu lakum deenakum wa atmamtu alaykum ni'mati wa raditu lakum al-Islam deena. Today I have perfected your deen and I have completed my blessing upon you, and I, Allah, have made Islam as your deen, have accepted and decreed that Islam is the only deen. So Umar radiallahu anhu, he said, I know when and where this ayah was revealed. It was revealed on a Friday where Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was standing on the day of Arafah. So number one, it is the day where our deen is completed. Second, it is a day where the Azim himself, Allah Azza wa Jal, swore by that day. And the greatest only swears by the greatest. Allah Azza wa Jal said, وَالسَّمَاءِ ذَاتِ الْبُرُوجِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْمَوْعُودِ وَشَاهِدٍ وَمَشْهُودِ. A surah that we all know by heart, where Allah Azza wa Jal swore by these 3 days. Abu Hurairah and Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, they said, Al-yawm al-maw'ud, here is the day of judgment. Wal-yawm al-mashhud, and the witness day is the day of Arafah. Wal-yawm wal-shahid huwa yawm al-jum'ah, it's the day of Friday. So Allah Azza wa Jal swore by this day. Another motivation for this day. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told us in a hadith in Sahih Muslim, fasting on this day, fasting on the day of Arafah for other than the Hajji, 2 years of sins will be forgiven, a previous year and a coming year. So that means 15 hours of fasting, 15 hours of fasting will delete 730 days of sins. Sins that you did not even commit yet. A previous year and the coming year of sins. Allahu Akbar. How great is Allah Azza wa Jal. Fourth motivation, subhanallah. Qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the hadith is also in Sahih Muslim. ما من يوم ما من يوم أكثر أن يعتق الله فيه عبدا من النار من يوم عرفة، وإنه ليدنو ثم يباهي بهم الملائكة فيقول: ما أراد هؤلاء؟ No day where Allah Azza wa Jal forgives or frees people from the hellfire as much as the day of Arafah. So this is Tuesday, is the most day that Allah Azza wa Jal will free people's neck. It will be decreed that this person is freed from the hellfire. That's the most day. I want my name to be on the list. May Allah make my name and your name and everyone who's watching us name on that list of the people whom their neck will be saved on the day of judgment. My brothers and sisters, when we are in the month of Ramadan, we all get very excited, masajid packed, because of the Laylatul Qadr, the last 10 nights. And we should. But we all know that the actual night is hidden. All we know, it's one of the odd nights in the last 10 nights. So we strive for 10 nights. Subhanallah, in this day, it is already known. So instead of 10 days, it's only one day. The day of Arafah is known. It is one day to strive and work extremely hard to earn all these rewards we just mentioned. Second, on the day or on the night of Laylatul Qadr, Allah Azza wa Jal said, تَنَزَّلُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ وَالْرُوحِ. On that night, the angels and Jibreel alayhi salam, they descend. On the day of Arafah, Allah Azza wa Jal himself descends, as the hadith we just narrated. Even though he descends on every single night on a way that befits his majesty, but on the day of Arafah, he descends on the daytime. Allah descends compared to the angels descend. So my brothers and sisters, this is a great ni'mah that we already know when is that day and the rewards that we will earn if we struggled and worked hard on that day. So inshallah ta'ala, I will suggest a schedule for me and you to try to apply, because simply we might make it to Tuesday and we might not. And every one of our beloved brothers and sisters that departed before Tuesday, they did not know that last Arafah was actually their last Arafah. Right? So what should we do? On Monday night, you go to sleep early, because you have a big day, the biggest day of the year ahead of you. You get up 1 hour. If you get up earlier, that is better. 1 hour before Fajr. Fajr 4:55, 4 o'clock, you put your alarm and you get up. You make a beautiful, perfect wudu, and you pray. 2 rak'ah, 4 rak'ah. And then you go and you have your suhoor, because you are fasting. You are fasting on that day. I want to get the ajr of 2 years of sins expiated. But leave 10 minutes before Fajr to make a lot of istighfar. Leave few minutes before the time of Fajr, not the iqama of Fajr, before the time of the Adhan of Fajr to make a lot of istighfar. Why? Because I want to be from المستغفرين بالأسحار. Allah praised the people who make istighfar at the time of suhoor. Astaghfirullah al-azim, alladhi la ilaha illa hu, al-hayy al-qayyum, wa atubu ilayh. Any form of istighfar, and the best form of istighfar is the one that the Sayyid of the Khalq called it Sayyid al-istighfar. Allahumma anta rabbi, la ilaha illa anta, all the way to the end. Say it once, twice. Make a lot of istighfar, and every istighfar, think of one of the sins that you have committed in the past, hoping that Allah has forgiven it. Now, the adhan is done. Brothers, make sure that day you're praying Fajr in the masjid. If the sisters would like to come, you are welcome. But I want to remind you that Rasulullah ﷺ said that your praying at home is better than praying in the masjid. You come to the masjid, my brother. You pray with the jama'ah. And you stay till the shuruq. During the whole 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, we are having a halaqah every single day till shuruq. And many of our brothers and sisters are joining. So on that day, you will come pray the Fajr in Jama'ah and wait till Shuruq, busying yourself in that time, either joining us in the Halaqa or reading Quran or making Adhkar. And then when the time is up, you wait 12, 13 minutes and you pray two rak'ah. What do I get? The promise of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Hajj, the ajr, the reward of Hajj and Umrah, tamma, complete. Does Rasulullah ﷺ have to repeat the word complete three times? Three times he repeated the word complete reward. We were deprived of being on Arafah this year. May Allah grant us Arafah next year. So let's get the ajr of Hajj and Umrah in Plano. With a simple total of maybe 1 hour, 1 hour of effort. This is the best day. I'm going to start everything from the morning to do my best. After we finish the Hajj and Umrah, you plan your day to do three things. Reading Quran, making all kinds of dhikr, remembering Allah Azza wa Jal, and making a lot of dua. Making a lot of dua, and the best dua is the dua between Asr and Maghrib. Dua is good all that day. But the best time is the time before Maghrib. The time between Maghrib, between Asr and Maghrib these days is around 3 hours. Wallahi, if you can, isolate yourself in the house, come to the masjid, and dedicate these 3 hours just for dua. Just for dua. Why? قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم خير الدعاء خير الدعاء دعاء يوم عرفة. The best of dua is the dua done on the day of Arafah. وأفضل ما قلت أنا والنبيين من قبلي. And the best thing I ever said, myself and every prophet before me, is لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير. That is the best dua you could ever make on the day of Arafah. Does that mean I don't say any other dua? No. Make any dua that you want, but make sure that this dua, this thana, this praise of Allah Azza wa Jal is the most that you will do on that day. Prepare your list from now. Prepare your list of dua from now. Prepare the list of the people that you will make dua for from now. If you are serious of saying at the end, my plan worked. Are you looking for a job? That is the day. Are you having health issues? That is the day. Are you having problems at home? That is the day to beg Allah.
Are you looking to have a child and you've been deprived from a child? That is the day. You're having in-laws issues. That is the day. You're having a lot of debt. That is the day. Ask people how many miracles were achieved because of the day they made on the day of Arafah, because of the dua they made on the day of Arafah. Make the list from now. Be ready in order to achieve as much as you can. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله وحده الصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده. My brothers and sisters, what do you think of making i'tikaf in the Masjid al-Nawawi for 30 days? 30 days of reading Quran, 30 days of making dua in the Masjid al-Nabawi, 30 days of praying so many janazas, 30 days of praying 5 daily salawat in congregation in the Masjid al-Nabawi, where Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the salat over there is better than 1,000 salat done somewhere else. Do you know what's better than that? قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لأن أمشي مع أخ لي في حاجة أحب إلي من أن أعتكف في هذا المسجد شهر. For me to walk with my brother, with my sister regarding a need of his is more beloved to me than staying in the Masjid al-Nabawi, isolating myself for a whole month. الله أكبر. So in these days, you have a brother that needs you to help him move. You have a brother that needs you to come and listen to his worries. He is going through such a hard time. You have a sister that needs some kind of help between her and her children. Any kind of help. Someone needs you to intercede for them to get a job. Anything. And keep in mind, this reward is just for making the intention to go and help. That does not include that the need is fulfilled. If it is fulfilled, forget about it. Another huge reward. Allah will keep the person steadfast on the day of judgment. Allahu Akbar. Finally, my brothers and sisters, every single one of us, maybe he knows someone is at Hajj, performing Hajj this year. Please text him sincerely and literally beg them to make dua for you. Why? Because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that on the day of Arafah, Allah azza wa jal will tell the people of Arafah, the actual people on Arafah, all your sins are forgiven and the sins for the people you made dua for. So beg them not to forget you. Tell them to make their list and throw your name in that list. My brothers and sisters, we all heard about the importance of these 10 days, the best 10 days of the year. And this is the only Jumu'ah in these 10 days. So officially, this is, we are witnessing the best Jumu'ah of the year. The best Jumu'ah of the year is today. So please, finally, every Jumu'ah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the last hour of Jumu'ah, the dua is answered. How about the last hour of the best Jumu'ah? The last hour of the best Jumu'ah of the year. So again, before Maghrib 8:30, 7:30, again for 1 hour, put all that things that you need and beg Allah with your own language. Let the tears flow and cry and beg and beg and beg. Subhanallah, when it comes to each other, we beg for so long and so sincere. But when it comes to Allah, we are so weak. Beg Allah Azza wa Jal, whatever you want, whatever you want. These are the best days, and this is the best hour to make dua. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from the people who on the day of judgment would say, my plan worked. Allahumma ighfir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم وفقنا لما تحبه وترضاه. اللهم وفقنا لما تحبه وترضاه. اللهم يا رب العالمين، يا أكرم الأكرمين، أغث إخواننا في إثيوبيا، وأغث إخواننا في السودان، وأغث إخواننا في اليمن، وأغث إخواننا المستضعفين في كل مكان. اللهم انصر المجاهدين في كل مكان. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، وأذل الشرك والمشركين. يا أرحم الراحمين، هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين، واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. وقوموا إلى صلاتكم.